It is hard to believe we've gotten all the way to episode 11, and we hope you're learning a lot about advanced remote workflows because, to be honest, we're learning a lot ourselves. My name is Michael, and in today's episode of Workflow from Home, we're going to tackle the second half of our discussion about remote review. Back in episode 3, we talked about how to deploy collaborative remote editing sessions. We built on that concept in episode 9, where we actually performed a synchronous cross-country remote 4K HDR color correction session with colorist Nick LaRoe in Vermont. But then in episode 10, we learned from the expert colorists at LightIron that live synchronous review isn't always the ideal way to work. It's certainly not the only way. Colorist Ian Vertovic describes the Posthouse as a centralized hub, and even though we can predict creatives will continue to leverage remote work, we can also predict that posthouses will still remain the central part for large-scale productions. You know, the term posthouse itself refers to a place that you visit for some length of time. It's welcoming, it's conveniently located, and it often has many of the comforts of home. But based on advances in technology and changing behavior, we can also predict that clients will spend more time outside of the posthouse. So let's discuss how some of the most advanced asynchronous collaboration review tools can enhance our workflows, remove technical barriers, provide greater clarity of communication, and most importantly, let us keep focusing on our projects and not worrying about our process. So what is asynchronous review? It's basically what the Frame.io mission and vision revolves around. We conceived Frame.io to power the world's video creation by designing the cloud-based workbench that centralizes creators with their content, collaborators, and even audience. We're talking about communication that spans numerous departments between key stakeholders who are all viewing content in locations worldwide while collaborating with the sender. But because tomorrow's remote workflows are more than just review and approval, Frame.io's third-party integrations and our API enable automation of many of these processes in remote collaboration in a new way. So to demonstrate this, we're going to examine some key workflow elements of review and approval for different stakeholders within a production. The first step to automate remote collaboration is to set up watch folders, which we covered in episode 2 when we discussed hybrid cloud workflows. Let's say an editor is working remotely and sets up a series of folders to export. These contain shared bins, cut lists, rough cuts, and notation documents. One method to automate and organize all these transfers is to replicate this structure in Frame.io so that you have a mirror of your desktop in the Frame.io cloud. Then, using the Frame.io Watch Folder application, which is available on the Mac App Store, you can auto-populate these folders. This tool lives in the upper right of your Mac OS menu bar. Using the Watch Folder app, you can set up multiple watch folders that can automatically populate assets into the Frame.io cloud. You can see that after exporting out a bin, a cut list, and a rough cut to the folders locally, the Frame.io Watch Folder app monitors or watches each local directory and then uploads that content automatically to the mirrored folder in the cloud. Then, Frame.io automatically notifies the appropriate people that a new file is available. This saves a lot of time because you eliminate the need for manual links and chasing notes over email. Now, review notes are timestamped, clearer, they include annotations and they're sortable, and you have a perfect log of all the assets to the reviewer. The updated Frame.io notifications are handy so you can quickly see who's read comments, see comment previews, and scrub asset thumbnails so you can easily spot what you need to review or address. Notifications are also nicely collected, which is great for large teams who are working on multiple projects that receive lots of feedback. It's always been easy to share an asset in Frame.io, but recently we added folder sharing, which includes functionality to keep the folder hierarchy in place. So now, when I select multiple assets, including folders, and share a link, everything has integrity. If I go to the shared link, I can see how folders and subfolders are maintained, keeping things organized. What's more, these links are dynamic. So if I were to add or subtract assets in my Frame.io project, they will be instantly updated on the recipient's end of the review link, all without having to resend another new notification. When it comes to high level of security, you have several options. Frame.io customers on the enterprise plan can share assets using invite-only privileges enabled. Invite-only means that your invited reviewer must be logged into a Frame.io account in order to access. With the new inbox view, you and your reviewers can avoid sorting through traditional email for all the links. You can remain in the Frame.io platform, all of your notifications clearly in one place, which is great for executives and key stakeholders. When it comes to asynchronous review, Frame.io allows you to be very specific with conversations that are designed to be fluid and simultaneous since they can essentially happen in real time. But the ability to add replies, manage threads, or tag specific people or departments allows you to easily track and trace notes, and of course, connect them to your other collaborators. For example, in this scene from The Lost Lederhosen, director Steven Shaw made a comment about his shot needing a push-in. He can select the whole shot using a Frame.io range-based comment, then use custom annotations to draw right on the image a start framing reference and then an end framing reference. We can articulate our comment and tag it as hashtag reframe. Because notes can be made for any number of people, the Frame.io search tool and use of hashtags in this way can be very powerful. For example, I could simply click on the hashtag reframe and it will show me all the shots where a reframe was tagged. I can even search for the names of the collaborators. So if I tag Barry Gotch, the editor of The Lost Lederhosen, every direct note to Barry becomes visible. When my notes are finished in this pass, we can change the status to in progress, and now it's time to return to the cutting room. With this kind of reviewer note detail, it's valuable for an editor to see it in the context of a timeline. So from the Frame.io account, Avid users can select the download icon, choose the download for media composer option. This exports an XML that can be imported into Avid as location markers. The Frame.io comments now display in your Avid timeline, and direct notes can be seen by the editor in line with the edit. They include details like the commenter's name, the date, time, and comment. For anyone using Apple Final Cut Pro 10 and Adobe Premiere Pro, these notifications can actually sync directly with your NLE between the Frame.io cloud platform and the Frame.io integration extension. This is a dynamic and real-time experience in which editors can see everything displayed directly as external comments are made. Unique to the Frame.io workflow extension in Final Cut Pro is a function called Presence. It allows the editor to monitor external reviews of the edit. Here from within Final Cut Pro, we can see Andrew making notes at specific time codes. The editor, Vince, can even gang the Frame.io viewer into his timeline. This way, as Vince cycles through the notes in the Frame.io control panel, it will drive the timeline playhead to the same time code. Another option is that Vince can download the notes and import them into the timeline as a compound clip. Everything is visible, even the annotations, which is useful for tracking notes directly in the timeline. It's integrations like these with Final Cut and Premiere Pro that allow everyone to have a fluid, real-time communication experience. Editors can respond within their own timelines, and they can remain in their creative space, maximizing their flow. Editors can even mark their work as done or complete or like it, so everyone receives a status update because everything is centralized and up to date in the Frame.io cloud. For effects artists using Adobe After Effects, Frame.io now supports background rendering. When the animator for this series, Abby, submits a render using the After Effects Frame.io integration, now she can continue working in other comps while rendering in the background. Once the Frame.io render is complete, the file automatically uploads into the Frame.io cloud and notifies collaborators. iOS offline mode gives you the ability to watch cloud assets even when you are not connected to the internet. Using either of the updated Frame.io mobile iOS apps, you can select Make Available Offline, and assets will download an encrypted file onto your iPad or iPhone. This allows users to make comments and annotations while in offline status. The moment you get a network connection, the comments will upload automatically and sync with the project in line with the other reviewer comments. For cinematographers making color notes, Frame.io is built into the Resolve application. For colorists working with online systems, DPs can make color notes into Frame.io and their notes will appear directly in Resolve as Frame.io markers. These markers automatically load and display the author, comments, and annotations. A colorist can then add a reply, which will sync back to the DP viewing in Frame.io. For Resolve systems that are air-gapped or not connected to a network, users can download the comments and import them into Resolve. In the Frame.io platform, the Resolve colorist navigates to the Comments tab and chooses Download as Resolve EDL. This Resolve EDL list can be copied over to the air-gap system. The colorist can select the matching timeline, choose Import, and load the marker's EDL to display the reviewer notes directly in the timeline, all without a network connection. Frame.io Enterprise Plan users now have an option to take security a step further with the Watermark ID feature. Here you can see a real-time, on-demand transcode of your video with your reviewer's information burned into every frame. There are even templates to choose from, or you can generate your own custom watermarks and change them dynamically for any link that you are sharing. The Watermark Template Editor allows you to customize settings to whatever you want to include. You can preview your work to see the watermark as it will appear in various aspect ratios, and you can manually move the watermark anywhere on the screen. then adjust the opacity and size of the watermark to see the result as you do it. There are even special behaviors such as text scrolling that add additional options, all of which can be saved in as a template. As soon as your reviewer receives the link and hits play, an entirely new asset is generated in real time, displaying all the custom info that you set in the template editor. Even a 2-hour clip with a custom burned-in watermark will be generated in seconds. Until recently, not every professional in the media and entertainment business had a reason to take such a deep dive into collaborative asynchronous remote review. This was partially due to not having proximity restrictions, but there were also concerns of security and resolution, quality and bandwidth limitations. But we learned in episode 8 from VFX founder of Zoic Studios, Andrew Orloff, that since remote work took off, there's been an emerging trend of more feedback that's not only vital, it's become expected when it comes to today's communication. If you're a creative, then you know that we create no matter what the external climate. We feel it's that desire to keep the creative process going that's driving everyone to solve unprecedented problems. Today's remote needs have shown us that people are starting to explore communication with higher precision, in less time, with fewer people, and in a constantly flowing cycle of bi-directional feedback. Frame.io exists because creative teams need a platform that not only allows artists to be completely centralized, but allows them to be completely fluid. In a way, the more people that get comfortable with working remotely, the better the remote tools will ultimately mature to be.